Like many this year, COVID also touched Marilyn's life unexpectedly, and she found herself in the care of physicians in the hospital. Mm. So you went to the hospital and you didn't even realize you had COVID. Is that right?
Well, I wasn't sure, you know, but
she didn't really have a lot of the symptoms.
The doctor thought I should go.
Yeah.
So I went, and, you know, we've been taught the word so much.
Yeah.
We speak promises to problems.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We speak to mountains and get what's on the other side.
Yeah.
So I thought, if I have COVID, I will be fine, you know, because I know how to speak promises.
Yes. Yes. Right.
Tell everybody what you do every morning. Like, again, I said, Marilyn's going to share simple yet profound truths.
Yes.
I really want you to listen to what she has to say, because it's so powerful if we all would do this every morning.
Yes.
And what is that?
Well, I speak 50 promises. I make coffee.
Right. Now, that's the anointing part right there. Amen.
And then I speak promises.
Right.
And I sometimes add some to it because I'm going someplace, maybe another country or something. So then I'll add some of those. But those promises are wonderful. And you can get up and feel like, oh, another day and I have all these things. But you speak the promises, I'm telling you, you get what's on the other side of the mountains. And I always think that.
Yeah.
You know, we're supposed to get what's on the other side.
Okay, so you're in the hospital, you have a little cough, and they put you in a room.
Yeah.
And so then what happened?
They had a wing for COVID. They put me in there. And the hospital is really nice, really nice. You know, I'm speaking promises. I know them by heart.
So you did that up in the hospital bed?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah.
So you had your phone and you were totally coherent.
Oh, yeah.
So yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And did you minister to anyone or pray for anyone?
A little. I tried. I tried. But, you know, it wasn't long. I didn't think I'd be in there long.
Yeah.
So I was in there like 4 days.
And then you came
and went home. Yeah.
And y'all say praise the Lord for that.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, how powerful is the Word of God when dealing with any situation in life?
Well, I think when you're in ministry, you get to practice a lot.
You sure do.
You know, so I think going overseas and being threatened, you know, and then I remember when I first felt that I was to minister, and a man said to me, of all the pastor's wives I know, you're the greatest example of a failure. Those are real encouraging things.
Oh, my
goodness.
And
so I said, why do you say that? He said, because all you do are those silly little home Bible studies. And see, I found that you could get women saved with a cup of coffee, a cookie, and a Bible.
Amen.
So my ministry all started very simple.
Oh, wow.
Very simple.
Now, what would you say if someone says, well, you know, the Bible, like it's a book with words. It's so much more than that.
Oh, yeah.
What is it about the Bible that's different?
It's living.
Mm-hmm. It's breathing.
I agree. And, you know, when I speak that in the morning, it is so wonderful to me. I mean, it's not, oh, I have to speak the promises.
Yeah.
It's like I'm getting my shots. Mm-hmm. I'm speaking what God says.
Yes.
And that's what's going to happen in my day.